Okay, here we are back inside MatrixGold. Thanks for tuning in. If it's your first time, I hope you find the video useful and helpful in your designing process. If you're a return viewer, I appreciate you watching the videos. I hope they're helping you out. And if you hit that subscribe button, I'd really, really appreciate that. And if you're a subscriber and return viewer, thank you so very much. The comments, everything, it's been absolutely outstanding. Really appreciate it, really do. On the last video I made with the Halo with a wire under gallery. I had a question, great question actually. So thank you so much for that. But she was asking if you know, you have the gems, if they all have to be one side, if you can change them to different sizes and be able to still keep all the parametric history. And the answer is yes. And not only that, you can move the stones around and you can also change the shape of the stones. So that's what I'm going to kind of really quick touch on. I saw the comment and I thought, well, this is just really great comment. And I wanted to try to get this up as quick as possible. So I'm just going to do a real quick explanation of how to do it. And later we'll go in and dive into a little bit more detail as far as everything goes. But this should show you the basic concept of trying to keep everything all parametric and putting different shapes and sizes and moving them around even and all the things that you have at your disposal in MatrixGold, and believe me, it is powerful. So let's go ahead and start this out. And you kind of, like Joseph said in the virtual summit, you kind of have to really think it through a little bit, or you'll spend a little bit more time doing it and getting it all ready. So the first thing we know is we want some large stones and we want them on our quarters. And then we want small stones in between, say, or you know, you can line them up however. But we'll go ahead, select our rail there. Right now, the only thing I have parametric is the gem offset. Of course, I don't have the gems to be able to orient them to the curve here. So if you haven't seen this part of the video, you probably want to go back and watch that other video. I think it's Halo Ring with Wire Under Gallery or something. The last video that was up to show how to do all this kind of stuff. But right now, everything is active. We all have our parametric history. So sorry for the long explanation. Didn't practice it. I'm kind of excited to do it, actually. So I'm going to go ahead and take that, and we'll go to our gems, and then we'll go to gems on rail, right? And right away, we have the gems out there. Now, the thing here is we want to go ahead and maybe get the size that we want here, and don't worry about here, here, and here yet, but the size that we want for this start one. Right now it's on zero, so we know that's on our 12 o'clock position. So I'm going to say I want this one to be a 3 millimeter, so I'm going to bump it up to a 3 millimeter, right? Now I'm going to drag this one over, and it's very important, you know, if you hold down shift, I think you can lock it in at the 75 position, right? But we have all these other gems we really don't want, right? So all you have to do is just go to your spacing. I keep grabbing that roll, but go to your spacing and then just space them out to where they're on your quads, right? So now they're all set up on the quads. Right, so now we'll just go ahead and accept that. All right, and now what we'll do is we'll go back to that and we'll do another gem on curve, and we'll kind of get our stones here. Oh, to see, I've been doing that all day long when I've been working. We'll go, just kind of grab them to where we want them. Oh, start position, our start position, right? And our end position, we want to move, kind of set it up here. And then we want to go in here and get our size that we want. I don't know how big we want them. Let's say around here maybe. And then just kind of deal with our spacing there. And then you can kind of move them around however you want. If you wanted three in there, you can make them smaller. So let's take them spacing. Let's take it down to a little bit smaller, and then you can make it open so we can snap in another one, maybe, depending on how big you want them. There you go. We'll just go ahead and take this for, and then you'll have to adjust your spacing as you kind of see it. So this will be the hard part, because you really don't have, you'll have to eyeball it, kind of getting the spacing to the same, right? And then let's just say we want that there. And next thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and take these, go back to our parametric, right? Target object, this curve here. Oh, I have to hold down Shift, Alt, select that curve because those three are grouped together. And so now those are locked in, and we'll hit that. And then we'll go back to these and edit those and go to our target surface. It's already there. Let's see if they're, did I grab the wrong ones? Let's check these out, make sure. Okay, this one, target. This curve here, hold down Shift Alt. Okay, so now they should all be locked into this. So now when I go drag this, hold down Shift and move it, they all update, right? So they're all, it's still all parametric. However I move them around, they're parametric. So what I can do now is I can select these stones and just go to my transform. And I can go to mirror, right? And then switch X, Y on and multi. And now they're all lined up, right? So now I have this. And if I want to go back in and move anything, this curve here, go back to edit, and I can drag them down, up, whatever. And then you can see it conforms with that. That's so cool. With that rail there. So that's active, and then I can actually take this one and do the same thing, and they all update, everything updates, right? But not only that, right? Say, you know, maybe, you know, that's a cool look and everything, but you're going for something a little bit different. You want some different kind of shape here. So now you can take those well, first we need to go back to our gems, and we'll just grab a regular gem out there, right? And hit enter and kind of make it a certain size or whatever you want. And then we're going to change that to a pear shape, right? And then hit enter. All right. So we have that. Now I can, what I can do is I can go at proxy gem, right? It's parametric. So I can go to my proxy gem, select my base gem. That'll be this one. Select my gems that I want to change. That'll be these, and hit enter, right? And now I have this, which they're going the wrong direction, which is no big deal. And let's just take that. Now, in order to move them around, right? I can select on them. The gem on curve is turned off, right? So I just go back and show it, right? So I turned it back on. So there's actually another gem in there, and that's the gem we want to select, I think. Yeah, that one. Now those gems are tied. So they're tied to these gems here, right? So I can go back in here. I can go to edit. And now find my original gem there, right? So I go over to my original gem. Let's turn on this so I can kind of see it a little bit better. And go to roll. And I can just roll them around to 180 degrees. If I hold down Shift, I think it'll lock it in, right? And I can change the size of them a little bit. Well, if I change the size, it'll change there, right? So go ahead and hit... yeah, this one it will enter. And now if I select these, I can go to my, well, don't select those, select your proxy gem, and then go to your proxy gem and hit edit and kind of keep a watch on it. And you can drag that proxy and that will update those other gems. So you can change the size of those other gems, right? Now I have something like that. Now if you don't like the position, you know, say, hey, that's a little way too close for my liking, you can also go back in and you can do the gem MSR, select gem, let's go ahead with this one, these four, and then hit enter, and it'll lock on that one, and then we can drag them out a little bit, right? And then hit enter. And actually, let's go back. I didn't forgot to hide those. So let's go back over here and we'll hide those original stones. So you can move it around and then you can go back in and edit anything. You want to move those stones around. You want to make them a little larger now or smaller or whatever. You can go back in and do all that kind of stuff. So let's make them a little smaller here so we can get three in there, right? And then hit enter. And everything is still tied together. So we go back over here and we can move those up and down and hit enter. And we can drag this curve here and hold down shift and move those around to any shape we want, right? But not only that, right? Say, you know, you like this kind of design, but you want to even add more into it as you go. So let's just take that gem again, go back to our MSR, it'll select them all, go back to our original. Now let's say I want to just drag this way out here like this, right? And then hit enter. And then I want to take these original stones and I want to edit them so that they go all the way around, right? You could even delete these and add other ones in if you wanted to. And let's get our spacing better. And let's do a little size it roll. I've been doing that all the spacing. Let's do a little size adjustment. Kind of get them lined up to where you want, right? Hit enter. That stone's not out far enough, so we want to go ahead and go back in and drag it out a little bit more. You can move it up and down, left and right, all different kinds of things, whatever you want. You can even rotate it a little bit more and hit enter, and everything is still parametric. And we'll hit enter there and we'll take this and go back. Oh, we don't need to go to parametric here. It's just tied to that. So there you go. You can do all kind of powerful things here. Now let's just take all our blue here and we'll just go to settings real quick, throw on some under bezels and you can manipulate them all day long. I'm just going to take that. Just, you know, like I said, I'll make something else later at a later date or whatever. You know, you can get rid of that head and put a different head in. There's all kinds of things you can do. But that hopefully gives you the idea of the power and how to go about keeping everything parametric as you move along. And I'll go back in here and actually make a little something using this so you can kind of see. Now the heads did not update there for some reason. Let's get out of that. Let's grab all that well, that's no big deal because you can just, you know, delete it and then go back, and probably because I did them all together, if you do them individually, let's check that out. Put the head on there. Yeah, it's parametric, it should update. Hit enter, and if I take this curve and move him around, yeah, it'll update. Yeah, probably do them separately, you know, do those and then do that, just to make sure it all stays the same. But hopefully that kind of gives you a little an idea of what you can do. If it does, please leave me a comment, let me know. And like I said, I'll go back and dig into this a little bit more. But I was kind of like, yeah, that's, you know, yeah, you can do that. So hopefully the video helps. And if it does, please leave a like, subscribe, and a comment below. Thanks for watching and good designing.